Orders. Now, if you didn't already see in the chat, at the player's request, we had Kai and Lee playing off stream, so that is happening right now. We'll try to inform you as soon as we have a result for that. Obviously, you'll be able to follow on the bracket, too.
Oh, it was for Jared for Arm Saga?
Yeah, we held a... There was a... Huh?
There's a rally. I thought it was just a normal raffle. I didn't buy a ticket. I would have done it for Jared.
Oh, it's fine. I'll tell you some stuff later about it. I have a plan.
Okay.
Yeah, for those of you who aren't aware, we're trying to... Because he didn't really make the Arm Saga compendium, we're trying to send Little Mac, Lazy Boredom, from North Carolina to Arm Saga. So we may be setting up a little donation... opportunity in the Smash 4 group. I may be setting that up here soon. So, if you feel like donating some funds to that, I'm sure he would appreciate that. But of course, no obligations. In the meantime, yeah, so we're waiting on the results of Lee versus Kai, but in the meantime, we're going to have Permilia versus Dandy Penguin here on stream for you guys. This is Loser's Quarters.
And we are going to see Permilia just go straight back into the core and I don't know, that Palutena's looking crisp. I'd like to see more of that.
Yeah, yeah, he probably just has that as a counter pick for just like maybe for certain characters or something. I'm not interacting with them. Alright, so we got the players banning stages right now, waiting for the first game to happen.
Permilia did just play, but he is in loser's bracket now, and as being stated before, Kai and Lee requested to play off stream.
Right, yeah, so. Alright, so Town and City for the first game in the set.
Oh!
Almost the same situation.
Yeah, just like the onslaught of forward airs.
Yeah. I feel like Pin is probably going to become more apparent in this matchup, or you know, more frequent, just because he may be able to use it to power through his projectiles.
Possibly, but if the Kanzo is close enough, Danny can still control it while he's pinned down.
Right.
Oh, Danny, yep, Danny was looking for that up air, confirm.
Alright, nice tech to roll in.
Backer still not going to do it. Already at 172, oh, 1 minute boy. Into the match. That will not clear it. Okay.
Such good option coverage from
Sakurai, Andy. Please.
Can I get another one?
Yeah, like.
There we go.
Ooh, 198.
Oh, goodness. Yep.
You know, almost 200% damage in the first, like, minute 15. That's pretty impressive.
Yeah. But Promelia's still hanging in there.
Ooh.
Nice tech. Alright, unfortunately it misses that back air.
Yeah, but gotta respect the option trying to keep Duck Hunt off stage. Because it's hard to get him out there.
Yeah, I mean, when Duck Hunt's forced into a situation where he has to use up B, and that's his only option, and he doesn't have Can covering him, I mean, he's, no pun intended, but he's a sitting duck.
Yeah, hey! I feel like Dandy's playing a little bit more aggressive and less projectile paced than he did before. Like, we're seeing a lot of follow-ups.
He is at 140%. I wonder if a, I'm fairly certain of this percent, Corn's up throw would kill.
Yeah.
Especially with this rage. Kane was in such a position that was helping, even though Dandy wasn't on stage, it was helping him have a presence still on at stage control of some sort.
Ooh.
That? Yep,
that
okay.
Will kill.
At 100%, this is going to be tough, but he can definitely do it.
Oh, absolutely. Oh!
Ooh, barely air dodges it.
Oh.
Yep, that can.
Yeah.
Breaking through.
Always comes through when you're getting comboed. Well, yeah, going for all the aggression. He needs it right now, though.
Yeah, I was about to say, I don't blame him. He almost had an early kill there. All right, smart. Retreats. He knows that if he gets any closer, that can's going to explode and kill him. Can't afford to get hit by the can right now.
Wonder if counter off the can would kill.
Yep. That'll take it.
Great frame trap right there.
Yeah.
You almost would just rather get hit by the can.
Yeah, I mean, that's the thing that Dandy does. You know, he'll keep you occupied. You can't do this option because the can's there.
So I want you to do this option.
You can't do this option. Yeah, he'll force you into doing something like for example, shielding a gunman.
Yeah.
So like, that way he knows he can just run up and grab you.
Well, we got a gunman shooting at you. We got a frisbee in the air. There's a can falling down.
And of course, it's going to be a matter of, you know, it's going to be a matter of learning how you react to those things. Because, I mean, he could, instead of shielding, he could jump, you know, and then if he keeps jumping, Dandy's going to realize that and he's going to forward air him, that kind of thing. But just like you, you got your wish, we got the Politana coming out for the second game.
Hey, man, I love seeing underrepresented characters. It makes me love Smash this that much more.
And already, you know, just like last set, it's almost the same thing. We can see, you know, the increase in mobility from having Politana.
And everyone just seems to think that taking Duck Hunt to town and city is like the greatest option in the world.
I don't know, man. There's something here that I'm not aware of.
It's Illuminati, man. We gotta find out.
Right. Yes, Dandy's still controlling space with those projectiles.
Vermillion, Dandy, both in the advantage situation where they're both playing characters not many people are familiar with. At a top level, anyway.
Woo! Neutral air?
Dandy has literally been clipping 80% of Vermillion's air dodges.
Familia trying to get back on stage here. He does get back. He has 143% though, so this is going to be tough. Poor gunman.
Dandy making quick work of these times, yeah.
Yep, that can. Going to take the first stock. 54%, almost the same situation as last game, I believe. Nice pivot grab.
Good dash attack. Already Dandy sitting at 102%.
Nice tech. Yeah, he's just kind of getting overwhelmed right now.
It's hard.
Trying to figure out what he can do. Oh.
Oh. Can game on Fleek, man. Like, literally. It's insane. It's so cool.
Yeah. Oh, nice. Oh, hits him with I believe it was an up air. Good awareness there on off stage.
I believe both of them went for the aggressive option right there. Dandy really had nothing to lose, though.
I mean, that's true. Vermillia is at a... Yeah, that's going to take
it. That is going to clip it. All right, I want to see not Town and City versus Duck Hunt.
Let's go to a larger stage here, probably.
No, smaller. I feel like smaller.
Or smaller, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, I can see that, because you don't want to give zoners a lot of room to work with.
So, don't give the zoner a lot of room to work with, and then if you force it to battlefield, Duck Hunt already has poor killing options that take forever.
Right.
And we're playing on they're playing on a stage with a low ceiling, so you incorporate a wider stage. Might work out better for them.
Yeah. Dandy doing really well. He is playing very well right now.
Yeah. Dandy has,
you know, like you said, his can game's been on point.
He has not missed many conversions tonight, and his frame trapping has been...
Yeah, no, it's definitely been there.
Pramelia pondering his options right now. He is on tournament stock for 6th, 5th place, I believe.
Loser of this gets 5th place.
5th place,
right. Speaking of which, in case you guys haven't noticed the bracket, we do finally have a result for Lee versus Kai. Lee did defeat Kai 3-2. So Lee moves on, and the winner of this will go on to fight Lee in loser semis. Just making you guys aware of that. Unfortunately, that means that Kai is eliminated to 5th place.
Probably a really hyped set, because Kai was playing really well. Corrin. And we are going to see him head back to Corrin.
All right, going to try something a little different. Going to take him to Lilat this time.
Smaller stage. He reaches through the platforms.
Yeah, and just like you said, you know, there could be some pin shenanigans to happen with the platforms too.
Yeah. Sorry, Dan, but Dandy is just like...
He's playing so well right now.
I want this man drug tested. He's playing too well.
I mean, there's really nothing else to say about it. It's not, you know...
Like, Pramelia is trying so hard to get in.
Absolutely,
and
yeah.
And Dandy is just literally covering every single option.
That can coming out.
Yeah.
Golly.
Can I get a can counter?
Okay, nice avoidance.
That could be it, man.
Yeah, unfortunately, that one's going to take it.
Dandy has clipped every single first stock within the first minute and 15 seconds of this set.
Just working quick. Already 33% off that one follow-up. And Pramelia just trying to figure out what he can do.
And it's hard because Corrin doesn't have, like... long, consistent follow-up. She has, like, her 2-4 hit combos at lower percentages, and then... You know what? Dandy keeping up the shield pressure. Very healthy lead right now. Pramelia's gonna need a hard read.
He's got to catch Dandy off guard somehow.
When he pulls out those gunmen, might be his only chance for a forward smash pin at a safe distance.
Possibly.
Pramelia already overlapping Dandy on percentage here on game 3.
Yeah, this is just not looking good for Pramelia right now. now I wonder... I wonder if instead of trying a pin, if he had tried a forward smash there, just, you know, I believe he might have been in range.
Yeah.
I wonder if that would have broke through and damaged him.
Finally getting a pin out. 131, possible tournament life here for Pramelia.
Yeah, it might be a little too, it might be too little too late, but we'll see if Pramelia can make some quick adjustments.
Oh my god,
oh my
man.
Goodness.
Yeah, okay.
That can is crazy.
His can game is nuts.
That can's enough of frustration. Okay, had a little something going on there.
Yep. That okay. Will be it. Dandy, very, very aggressive projectile play.
Yeah,
and I respect it.
He just said he had no idea.
Dandy.
Good stuff to Pramelia. Playing very, very well.